Now to an NBC2 News alert. Biologists now believe red tide killed this whale shark. Its massive carcass washed up on Sanibel Island on Sunday. Those tests confirmed today. And these pictures all coming in, also coming into the NBC2 newsroom. Rescuers say they took in two massive loggerhead sea turtles poisoned by red tide as well. Just yesterday, we told you red tide was to blame for killing off 19 turtles. And Crow, the rehab clinic on Sanibel Island, very, very busy these days. Red tide levels are high up and down the Gulf Coast.
Yeah, people are reporting fish kills and breathing problems at beaches from Collier County all the way up to Sarasota. NBC2's Ashley Dyer is live at Fort Myers Beach to explain how much longer this red tide is expected to last.
The worst part about this situation, no one knows exactly when it will end. This bloom was discovered back in October, and as of now, there is no clear timeline as to when it will get any better.
The environment is telling us it's not healthy.
This red tide algal bloom was first noticed last fall. Through its 10-month span, the bloom has killed thousands of sea creatures.
Both these turtles were recovered in the last couple days.
The naturally occurring algal bloom usually lasts only a couple months.
This is unusual when we have this level of persistence.
For almost a year now, we've seen the side effects of red tide, and lately, we're really feeling them too.
So as soon as we came over the bridge, we noticed a different sense of odor. And just a change in like coughing and sneezing once we got out of the car.
Wind makes red tide symptoms worse.
The past few days, you'll notice on this map here, we've had winds in an onshore fashion, meaning they're pushing the air from the west and the southwest. If you're on the beach, any smell of red tide is going to get pushed right toward the beaches.
The intensity of the bloom is impacted by rainfall, but there are other major issues that play a role.
And it comes down to the same thing. It's water quality. It basically took us 70 years or so to get to this point. It's going to take a while to get back out.
A beach hazard warning is in place from the National Weather Service through tonight for all coastal Lee, Collier, Charlotte, and Sarasota counties. As of now, the red tide season is expected to last throughout the summer. Live in Fort Myers Beach, Ashley Dyer, NBC2.